So now we're going to cook what is known as a jeera pulao, or a cumin and vegetable rice dish. Pulao is a rice dish that where the rice is sautéed before being cooked. And it's a traditional North Indian rice preparation that has come from as a result of the Central Asian and Persian invaders in India that brought their rice preparations with them and influenced the Indian way of preparing rice. So what we're using for this is basmati rice. So basmati is the long-grained, rather more expensive rice that is always used for these sorts of pulao preparations. It's never used for dishes where the rice has to be ground or turned into a batter or anything like that. Always when the rice is served whole, you use this high quality rice. Basmati is aged like wine, and it's always advisable to, when you purchase it, to buy a sack where there's a window pane and you can see the grains inside and you can make sure that they're not broken and that the quality is nice, fine, long grain, separated rice. One of the things that is very important with preparing this or any sort of rice dish is to wash your rice. You must wash it really thoroughly until the water starts to run almost completely clear. So using a mesh colander such as this is a really good way to do it. So the first thing you would do is put your 2 cups of rice in here, and under running water, use your hands to massage the rice and keep looking down and having a look and seeing what the color of the water is looking like. If it's still looking very chalky and white, then you want to keep rinsing. Once it comes through a little bit more clear, then if you have a bowl that is large enough for this, for your colander, whatever colander you're using, to sit inside the bowl, then that is the best way to soak your rice. You sit the colander into the bowl and fill the bowl up with water. The reason for that is because then you can simply, when it's time to use the rice, you can simply just lift out the colander, drain out the water, and it goes straight into the pan. The other option is to just put the rice into a mixing bowl and cover it with a couple of inches of water and let it soak. Now, different recipes will advise different soaking times. If you're doing a biryani, which is a more complex Indian rice dish, they will even tell you to soak the rice overnight. The reason for soaking is because the rice actually absorbs some of the water and the grains elongate. And when you fry it in the hot ghee or oil, they puff up and they stay more separate when you cook it, so that you get a less mushy result. The hallmark of a really well-cooked Indian rice dish is that all the rice grains remain separate. This is a traditional cooking method that comes from Persia. Today we're using the absorption method, which means that we're using double the amount of water to the amount of rice. So today we have 2 cups of rice in the recipe, so we're going with 4 cups of water. This is the proportion that I find works for me. You will come across recipes that will give you 1.5 times or 1¾ times the amount of water. But I find that the rice stays slightly al dente. If you prefer that texture, then you can use less water. Otherwise, go with the double proportion that's advised in this recipe. So I'm just going to strain out the soaking water and come back. Okay, we're back after having strained the water out of the soaked rice. So this rice has soaked for about 4 hours. And if you see, this is the dry rice prior to soaking. If you look at the length of the grains and also the color, and this is the rice after it is soaked. And you can see that the grains are not only whiter, but they've also elongated and grown up in size because they've swelled up with some of the water. You do want to try and let as much of the soaking water drain out as possible before it goes into your pan, because using rice that is too wet in the pan will not result in as fluffy an end result as you would like. So the ingredients that we're using for this pulao is a variety. The oils that we're going to use are a mixture of ghee, which is clarified butter, and grapeseed oil, a little of each. After those have heated up in our pan, we will go in with some whole spices. The whole spices are cardamom, green cardamom. So this is green cardamom, which comes in this dried light green pod. And we're only using one for this recipe. You can use two or three if you really like the flavor. It does lend a beautiful, almost perfumed flavor to the rice. And for the purposes of this recipe, we're gonna just snip off the tip so that some of the flavor and aroma can escape a little bit more easily without letting out the seeds. The seeds live in the inside of the cardamom pod, which, depending on how fresh it is, you can break sometimes with your nail or just with the knife. When you open up the husk, you have a nest of little brownish black seeds inside. There's usually about 10 to 11 seeds per pod. And when you buy pre-ground cardamom powder in the stores, that is just the seeds that have been ground up. For those of you who are not familiar with the flavor of cardamom, as soon as one mentions chai, most people can pinpoint the flavor that I'm talking about. Cardamom is the essential flavor in chai masala or Indian tea masala. So in rice preparations, you always use the pod whole, and in other dishes, you would use it the seeds ground down. You can either buy the seeds ground or you can open each pod and grind the seeds yourself. Cardamom has a flavor profile that is citrus and also floral, and it also has a menthol in it. So when you eat one of the seeds, you'll find after a few seconds that the part of your mouth where you've chewed the seeds becomes cool. So it's used also as a breath freshener in India. People will chew on the seeds after a meal as a breath freshener. So we're going to use cardamom, we're going to use whole cumin seed, we're going to use cassia, which is this, which is the Ceylonese, or from, it's from South India, the cinnamon stick that we used in, that we use in India. It's more like a bark, and it is a cousin of cinnamon. It is easier to use, it has a slightly smokier aroma than traditional cinnamon quills, and it's also easier to use because it's very easy to snap and break, as opposed to cinnamon quills, which are much harder to work with. So you'll find in Indian stores, they're often just labeled as flat cinnamon sticks. So we use that, and we also have some salt and some turmeric powder. The turmeric powder will color the grains of rice yellow. You don't have to use turmeric, you can just leave it white as well. And then we've got a couple of small bay leaves. And then the vegetables that we're adding into the rice today are green peas and diced carrots, but you can also add green beans if you like, and even finely chopped zucchini if you have that in your fridge. So we're going to start by heating up our pan. We're using a nice deep-sided pan here, which will take the 2 cups of rice and the 4 cups of water comfortably and leave enough space for it to grow in size. So we're going to put in our ghee. And a tablespoon of oil. As you can see, very precise measuring is not entirely required for most of these dishes. It's not an exact science as would be baking or anything like that. The measurements are there as a guide. Certainly in terms of the whole spices, you can always afford to put a little bit more. The powdered spices, you do have to be a little bit more accurate, especially spices like chili powder and things where heat is concerned. And turmeric also, you do want to be a little careful because too much can lead to a metallic taste. So you want to go in with your cumin seeds, your cinnamon stick, your bay leaves, your cardamom pod that's been snipped. And these are ajwain seeds, which were also used in the okra preparation, the cousin of oregano. And this adds a lovely herbal note to the rice. And then from there, we let our spices sizzle for just a few seconds. And then we add all our rice. And we stir briskly along with the salt. The idea is that you're trying to get the rice to be coated with the ghee and oil mixture, because by coating the rice, then when you add the water, because water and oil don't mix, you get a fluffier result. And then we put in our turmeric. I'm just going to add a tiny bit. Again, you don't have to add this if you want to keep it white. So you want to mix it in the oil for a couple of minutes, or a minute. Don't worry if it sticks a tiny bit on the bottom, because when the water goes in, that will all come off. We're going to add in our peas and our carrots. This is a especially pretty rice dish with the contrasting colors. And then you're going to add in your 4 cups of water. And make sure that you draw all the rice down from the sides of the pan. That's really important, because you don't want it to stick and burn. And you also want to drag your spoon across the bottom of the pan to make sure that anything that's stuck down there gets mixed with the water and that the cooking is even. Okay, then you're going to bring this mixture up to a brisk boil, to the level where you're seeing bubbles in the sort of towards the center of the pan, and then you cover it, turn it down to a low, medium-low simmer, and simmer it for 10 minutes. We're back after the rice has had a few minutes to come up to the boil. So you're looking for a brisk boil and lots of bubbles all around the edges coming in towards the center. And then you want to turn it down to medium low to low. So it's still steaming, but the bubbles subside a little bit. And then you cover it and give it exactly 10 minutes on the timer. And once that 10 minutes is up, you want to turn off the heat, turn off the timer, and just leave it be for 5 minutes, completely undisturbed. So you could set a 15-minute timer, and then when it gets to 10 minutes, gets to 5 minutes, just turn it off, or do two separate timers. But the initial 10 minutes is very important to make sure that you keep to that time so that the rice doesn't overcook. Okay, so we're back after the rice has had 10 minutes to cook, as well as 5 minutes to steam. So 15 minutes in total. The gas went off after the 10 minutes, and then it was just left alone for 5 minutes. So we're gonna take the lid off. And you can see we'll just pick off. You want to definitely pick off any of the whole spices that have risen to the top, like the cinnamon and the bay leaf. The cardamom is often harder to find, but today it's presented itself right at the top. I think there's one more piece of cinnamon floating around in there somewhere. So that's what that looks like. And you should be able to fluff it very easily with a spoon. And as you can see, each grain is separate, and it's not mushy. So we can serve that onto a serving bowl. Found the second cinnamon stick. It's just a very light golden, because I just used a little bit of the turmeric. You can see the lovely contrasting colors of the carrot and peas. You can garnish this rice with fried onions or fried shallots, which can taste delicious. And that is your complete meal. So the five dishes that we covered are the sauteed South Indian potatoes, the spiced okra, the fried fish or tareli machi, the tarka dal, and the cumin pulao. All of these five dishes can be eaten, can be served together as one meal if you're entertaining. Or typically in India, you would eat rice, dal, and vegetable, either of the two vegetables together with the fish. So I hope you prepare these dishes at home and enjoy them. And if you have any questions for me, please do feel free to comment or contact me at my email address. Again, that's Kesar Kitchen, K-E-S-A-R Kitchen, all one word, @gmail.com, or post on my Facebook page. Thank you.